Hi, this is Chris with Splunk Education. In this video, we'll investigate some simple ways to monitor Splunk user activity in your environment. We'll cover how to monitor login activity and the types and frequency of searches that your users are running. First, we need to understand a few things about Splunk's internal indexes. Splunk logs all sorts of information about itself, including performance and system data, scheduler activity, system errors, and user activity, in three primary internal indexes. By default, the data in these indexes is only available to users with an admin role. For the purposes of this video, we'll focus on the Audit Index, where you can find events related to user activity, including user logins, login failures, users modifying a setting, or running a search. Let's start by taking a look at the events in the Audit Index. If you're logged in as an administrator, you can run a search for index=audit. In the events, you can see the user's name, what action they took, and detailed information of what they did. To know when a user login fails, we add info=failed. Looks like people have been, mistyping their password a lot. While one failed login attempt might just be user error, a pattern of failed login attempts may hint at something more sinister. Let's count and sort these events by user to see if we have any repeat offenders. We can now use this report to reach out to users that may be having issues, or block connections from people being naughty. This search will come in handy, so we'll save it to a dashboard. While it's good to track all failed login attempts, it's an especially good idea to keep an eye on failed logins by admin user. We'll keep our existing search constraints, but narrow our search to just return events containing the admin user. A large amount of failed admin logins can suggest a dictionary attack is being run against our server. We want to know as soon as the attack starts so that we can lock down our environment. For this, we create an alert. We save the search as an alert, give it a name, and set the alert to run in real time. Real-time alerts run searches continuously in the background, so they should be used sparingly and only when absolutely necessary. In this case, we should only be searching a small amount of data for an important purpose, so we can justify the workload. As we mentioned, mistakes happen, so we'll set this alert to only trigger if there are 10 failures within a minute. We can throttle this to only trigger once for 10 minutes, so there's time to take action once the alert is triggered. We'll use the webhook alert action to send the alert to our security desk at Buttercup Games. Now, we are prepared to take action if an attack should happen. The Audit Index is also a great way to see searches our users are running, so we can help them be more successful with their searches and tune any searches that may be causing issues. Let's search the Audit Index again for searches that were successfully run and examine these searches by user and frequency. This time, we will query for actions with the value of search and use the info field to limit our search to only the searches that were successfully run. We pipe our search into a stats command that will count the searches by search and user and then sort the counts. Oh, come on. Looks like someone needs a talking to. Well-crafted searches are one of the best ways to improve Splunk performance, so it's a good idea to periodically examine the searches your users are running. We'll add this search to a dashboard so we can keep an eye on it. While bad searches can tax your system, Bad saved searches can bring your deployment to its knees, especially if they have been scheduled to run automatically. We can view the saved searches that were run using the saved search name field in the Audit Index. Splunk System User is a system-level account responsible for running the searches needed for system jobs, such as summary indexing and report acceleration. We'll filter out these jobs, as well as searches run from our admin account, and use a stats command to return an easy-to-read table of how frequently these searches are being run by each user. Finally, we'll use a sort command to display the major offenders first. Ugh, as you can see, we have a user that has scheduled a search to run every few minutes. As an admin user, we can access this report and change its scheduling settings to something a little more reasonable. And afterward, maybe we'll send a gently worded email to the culprit. As you can see, this is some really useful data stored in the Splunk internal indexes. We suggest you dig in and see what you can find in your data. To learn more, we suggest you check the documentation, watch additional videos at our Splunk How-To channel, or register for courses from Splunk Education. Thanks for watching.